Governor, members of Russian and Norwegian Parliament, Council General and other participants. First of all, thank you for your kind invitation, and I'm very happy to be back here in Sofia and beautiful St. Petersburg and back at the university. I'm very pleased to be invited to talk at this important international seminar about opportunities and cooperation in High North. I will also take the opportunity to congratulate Governor Alexander Tustenko with the result of the election this week. As a mayor of the Nordland County, I think it's very important to follow up the future and growth cooperation between Leningrad and Nordland County. It started as it was held as early as in 1987. In 2 years, the cooperation has been going on for 30 years. And yes, we are going to celebrate. We like to continue the cooperation for many, many years to come. I will also take the opportunity to say some few words about my county. Nordland is a diverse county in Norway, both in terms of landscape and business. Location is strategic in the north when it comes to oil and gas, mining industries, minerals, transportation, tourism, safety, and preparedness. A number of international companies in these industries are established in Nordland. Some of the issues that I discussed in the successful visit in Bodø last October with Governor Tustenko and his delegation. We have opportunities in Nordland that can prepare for attractive jobs both in Norway and in other countries as well. To be a foreign student in Nordland will give you a lifetime experience. There are nearly 900 foreign students in Nordland, and so far as 35%, this is about 400, including internet students, come from Russia. This includes studies in a variety of subjects, with emphasis on economic and technology and management. We want to attract foreign students that can make contacts in Nordland, which can use when they return back home to work in public or private sectors. In this way, new relationships can be established between companies as well. Today, we have nearly 1,000 inhabitants from Russia. This number increased year by year. That means that Russia is very important for Nordland. We really need foreign workers in many sectors and hope that the students and others can be recruited. I hope that we can increase the number of our students from Nordland who want to study for a longer or shorter time in Russia. We must actively encourage and use the scholarship schemes Russia also makes available. Well, similarly, St. Petersburg and Leningrad have a diversity that makes the area particularly attractive for those who want to invest in Russia. The Norwegian company, Jotun, who in the last year opened its new plant in Leningrad, is a good example of this. Although there are major differences in language, areas, and of course, population population size, it's worth recalling that the distance in Tsiadopoli from Buda to St. Petersburg is no longer than to our capital. The University of Norland is one of our most important partners in efforts to develop Norland County. We provide funding for development projects, and we have a strategic partnerships in a variety of areas. Several of these have a basis in cooperation with Russian partners. This is a long-term commitment that we will maintain. Another important body within Norwegian and Russian cooperation is the Norwegian Barents Secretariat. The Barents Secretariat is owned by the three Norwegian-owned counties, Nordland, Troms and Finnmark. And it's financed by the Norwegian Ministry of Foreign Affairs and supports more than 200 Norwegian-Russian projects every year. I would particularly draw attention to our efforts to increase the scope of research. Business development with an international perspective will be a priority. Russian business partners will in many areas be important to engage. However, culture and people-to-people cooperation is also important, and our focus on our youth is never wrong. Governor Drostenko and our county governor, Mr. Thomas Norwood, intend to follow up the cooperation in fields like energy savings, waste management, aquaculture, plan and development. I will salute to you who started this cooperation and year after year have been able to renew and it in line with new challenges. You have demonstrated an ability to be innovative and to face the new opportunity. I wish you all good luck with this seminar. Thank you for your attention. Спасибо большое.
Thank you very much, Mayor of Nordland County, Sonja Steen. I should also have informed you that we will let each speaker say what they would like to address you. And then, when they're finished, we will open for questions. So you can prepare for questions to all the speakers and we will give our session after that. There is also a change in the program. Vladimir Torlopov could not come. So we decided that we will give the Norwegian speakers will now have their turn. And we started with the vice governor and we will also end with a Russian representative of the city of St. Petersburg. So therefore it is pleasure for me to introduce the next, and that is Eirik Sivertsen. Eirik Sivertsen, he is a member of the Norwegian Parliament, Stortinget, and he is elected from Nordland County for the Labour Party. Eirik Sivertsen is a very close friend of us and all the cooperation that we have been developing during the past years. And today he is also the head of the Norwegian Parliament's delegation to the Arctic, or for Arctic Parliamentarian Cooperation. And if I'm not mistaken, all the national representatives, the national heads of the Parliament's delegation for Arctic issues, they are gathered now and then, and Eirik Sivertsen is the chair of their meeting. So we are very happy that you could be with us, Erik Sivertsen. The floor is yours.
Thank you for those very kind words. Chair, Vice Governor, honorable guests and friends, thank you very much for inviting me to this seminar in beautiful St. Petersburg. This is the first time I have the opportunity to visit this city, and I already see that I have to come back again. And thank you for allowing me to address such highly competent body of expertise. I am also an inhabitant of the north. I live in Bodø, the capital of Nordland County. I am also very proud of the long cooperation between Nordland and Leningrad Bloods. I'm very proud of the cooperation also between the University of Nordland and the Baltic State Technical University. I would like to start by underlining the importance of international cooperation in the Arctic and by celebrating the Arctic Council. The Arctic Council is a success. During its relatively short time of existence, 19 years, it has been instrumental in establishing the Arctic as a zone of cooperation. The Arctic Council has been an innovative governance structure by having the states and the indigenous peoples, known as permanent participants, around the same table, and with a strong link to the science community, which delivers world-class research as a basis for the Arctic cooperation. The Arctic science community has also developed a new way to include traditional knowledge of the indigenous people in their research. By combining modern science and traditional knowledge, the working groups under the Arctic Council have delivered reports which has been the basis for the state representatives in their decision making. The overall and common goal for all Arctic states is to maintain the high north and Arctic as a peaceful and stable region. The Arctic Council has played a key role in establishing a broad understanding that is the UN Convention of the Law of the Sea, which constitutes the legal framework for governing the Arctic in an international perspective. In the north, all the Arctic countries share a common goal about peace, a peaceful and stable region. The Arctic Council Ministerial Meeting in Iqaluit this spring also underlined the need for continued cooperation in the Arctic. And the foundation for the Arctic cooperation is the international law. As Arctic partners, both Russia and Norway expect all countries to respect and obey this. Norway also expects Russia to respect international law everywhere. Therefore, we do not accept Russia's actions in Ukraine. And in this context, I would like to underline the importance of preventing spillover effects from disagreements in Ukraine into the Arctic cooperation. Despite the fact that Norway disagrees with Russia's action in Ukraine, we want to keep the Arctic as a zone of peace and international cooperation. The Arctic Council has now more than 32 observers which are eager to contribute to the Arctic cooperation. More countries and organizations have applied, and I'm sure that the Arctic Council will find good ways to utilize this opportunity. One of the most important ways observers can contribute is through the scientific cooperation in the working group of the Arctic Council. But the Council has to sit down and discuss how do we utilize this, and this will be on the table in the coming years. Colleagues, in order to find the best possible way to manage challenges in the Arctic, it is important to bear in mind that there is not only one Arctic. There are huge differences between various parts of the Arctic. The environment, climate, infrastructure, and geographical distances are fundamentally different along the ice-free coast of Norway compared to the north of Alaska. In my mind, the real experts of the Arctic are the people living in the Arctic. The citizens of the north, including local and regional authorities, must have the opportunity to provide knowledge and premises for further development of the Arctic. The overall goal is to use the opportunities that are emerging in the Arctic in a sustainable way, which serves both local communities, national interests, and our international responsibilities. we need to explore how local population can strengthen their participation in decision-making processes in the Arctic Council. We have to establish better ways to hear local and regional voices. It can be argued that development in the Arctic over the last few years have been driven with an international and national perspective and not so much with a local and regional perspective. This must, in my view, change. For an example, I think that St. Petersburg, you have a lot of expertise on the Arctic and can play an important role in Russian policymaking of the Arctic. We, as international parliamentarians, cannot and do not wish to dictate how the various countries in the Arctic run their affairs. They are all sovereign nations, but we can promote the exchange of good practices on how different countries have met this challenge. Friends, we are now at a point in time where there is considerable attention on utilizing the possibilities for business in the Arctic, a region with vast natural resources. Last week, I was in a panel discussing the expectation for the Arctic Economic Council when its secretariat opened in Tromsø. The social benefits and costs are potentially huge in many of the development projects in the Arctic, especially related to exploitation of natural resources. The impact on small societies when new industry is opening up with potentially thousands of workers is dramatic. So, how do we meet this? A close dialogue between the industry, governmental representatives and the local communities on the implementation of corporate social responsibility is, in my view, of paramount importance. I welcome the Arctic Economic Council as a constructive partner in the Arctic governance structure, while we make sure that we still pay close attention to what other stakeholders in the Arctic have to say. Also, I would like to underline the educational institution have to play a key role in the Arctic, in developing further knowledge about the Arctic. About the North, in the North, and for the people living in the North. The long-lasting cooperation between the University of Lolland and the Baltic State Technical University is an example to inspiration for other institutions. Dear colleagues, in the end of August, I attended the Glacier Conference in Alaska. The conference was hosted by Mr. John Kerry, with President Barack Obama as a keynote speaker. The aim was to focus the effects of climate change in the Arctic and the need for an ambitious international agreement in Paris in December. I see this as a follow-up on the conference statement of the parliamentarians of the Arctic regions, big conference last year in Baikonur, Canada, where we ask the governments of the Arctic nations, the all eight Arctic nations, to raise a strong Arctic message in Paris this year. The meeting in Paris is, in my view, the most important Arctic meeting this year in the whole world. The last years we have seen the Arctic states have negotiated legally binding agreements on search and rescue and oil spill preparedness and response. We also have seen the five Arctic coastal states need to negotiate agreements, the latest one in July, this summer, on fishing in the international waters of the Polar Sea. I find this way of translating the Arctic Council cooperation into a framework for addressing new areas in an innovative way interesting, and welcome this development. It is, however, important that we keep the Arctic Council as the primary basis for cooperation in the Arctic. Thank you for your attention.